Hey guys, John Muir from Restoring Reason with John Muir. And over the weekend, in case you missed it, Jimmy Kimmel, the late night comedian who's actually not that funny in the first place, decided that he wanted to take to Twitter and call for a truce, an end to his week-long feud that's been going on with Fox News host Sean Hannity. Now, this all started a week ago Monday when after he was showing some video of the White House Easter festivities, you know, the nice event where a bunch of children are brought together, they get to spend some time with the president and the first lady, they get some Easter eggs, they color pictures. Everybody puts partisanship aside for a little while so everybody can just have a nice time and do it for the children. Well, apparently it was too much for Jimmy Kimmel because as soon as they got done playing footage of what was going on at the White House that day, on his show that night, he decides to go imitating the first lady's accent, making fun of her for being an immigrant. Illegal immigrant, might I add you. But anyways, isn't that kind of interesting the way that works? Because I thought we were supposed to be tolerant of all people from other countries. I thought we were supposed to be accepting. I thought we weren't supposed to go insulting people for things they can't control. I mean, you keep hearing it from Kimmel's buddies on the left all the time about how you have to be tolerant and how Republicans are these horrible, intolerant people. But then when the chips are down, time and time again, we see Democrats failing on their own policies. They're a bunch of hypocrites, and Jimmy Kimmel, he's one of the biggest of them. So Sean Hannity, he calls him out. He calls out Kimmel for what he was doing because it was wrong. It was disgusting. But Jimmy Kimmel, of course, goes responding, and he made matters worse. Then he goes after Sean Hannity, and well, you're not supposed to insult immigrants, and Kimmel did it. Well, then Kimmel went breaking another one of the left's rules because he went after Sean Hannity, who, might I add, is a straight male, and made homosexual comments about him and President Trump. He was making it to be a joke, an insult if you were gay, which I thought the left was supposed to be all loving and tolerant of them too, but apparently not. So anyways, the two of them are going back and forth for a while, and then yesterday, Kimmel issues a statement where you think like, okay, maybe this is nice. I'm surprised, but maybe the guy came to his senses. Well, no. It is like the worst apology I have ever seen in my life. This guy comes out here and he tries to say the whole, oh, we all need to do better thing, and he says that he stands by his comments that he made about our first lady. The insults of her heritage. No, not everybody needs to do better. The only person in this situation, Jimmy, that needs to do better is you. You need to do better. You need to stop trying to make your show, which is meant to make people laugh after a long day when they come home and turn on the TV at night. You're supposed to make them laugh instead of just trying to make it a one-hour political piece against this president. If you want to do that so bad, you should apply for a job at CNN or MSNBC. But no, you take your form and use it wrongly. You know what? People are tired of it. That is why you are failing in the ratings compared to people like Jimmy Fallon. You are absolutely terrible at your job, and you are just trying to attack the president, attack his family, attack common sense Republicans left and right, because you know that is the only way that you can actually get people to tune into your show. All those hate-filled Democrats will watch it, but you know what, the rest of America, they don't care. They want nothing to do with you. It is absolutely pathetic that after all of this, after the wrongdoings you did this past week, you are trying to say that we all need to do better? No, nobody's perfect, but at the same time in this one, you need to say mea culpa, because this is on you, buddy. But you're not even a man enough to do that. It is absolutely pathetic. Jimmy Kimmel, you are a little boy who still does not understand that when you make a mistake, you gotta own up to it. Apparently nobody taught you that. It's absolutely pathetic. He still won't apologize to the First Lady. He owes Sean Hannity an apology. Instead, we get some fake piece of crap supposed apology that's not even worth the paper that it is written on. So for everybody, I would just encourage, a lot of you, you're already doing it right. The rest of you, any of you who are still watching Jimmy Kimmel's program, I would advise you to stop, because you know what? It went from being late night entertainment, it went from telling jokes and trying to be funny, to being a political hit piece. If you want to talk politics, save it to the experts. Save it to people who actually have degrees in political science. Save it to people who actually know the facts, and don't trust some worthless piece of crap like Jimmy Kimmel, who probably couldn't even get a job on the Clinton News Network. That's how bad he is. It's sad. That's everything that we got for you today, but tune in tomorrow morning and every weekday morning on WTAQ, WHBL, and WSAU for Restoring Reason with John Muir. For now, I'm out.